Hello everyone, my name is Tyler, and this week I'll be going over the different emission types you can have in Unity, and I'll be showing you how to create a basic explosion effect using what we've learned so far, and also using a preview of what we'll be going over next week, which is shape. So, without further ado, let's get started. Now, there's two different kinds of emission that you can have in Unity. The first one is time, and then the second one is distance. Now, time-based emission tells the emitter to spawn a number of particles per second. So right now we have it at 10 particles per second, and if we increase it to 25, the emitter will spawn 25 particles per second, and if we decrease it to 5, the emitter will only spawn 5 particles per second. Now, the second thing that you can do with time-based emission systems is tell the emitter to spawn a burst of particles based on the time here. Now, this is based on the duration of the emitter itself. So when the duration of the emitter hits the time specified here, which is 1 second, it will spawn the number of particles specified here, which is 30. So if I stop it and then start it again, you'll see that once this hits 1, every time the particle system loops through, it'll spawn 30 particles, which is pretty handy for the explosion effect that we're going to want to use later. So for the second type of emission, which is distance, I'm going to go over to another particle effect real quick. And here you can kind of see a preview of what we'll be able to do later on, but I wanted to go to it real quick to kind of show you what distance-based emission looks like. So distance-based emission basically spawns the number of particles based on the location of an emitter over a certain amount of time. So right now you can kind of see a bunch of little orange particles are being spawned following this kind of medium-sized orange particle over here. So that what basically is happening is these little orange particles are being spawned based on how far the medium-sized orange particle is from the spot that it was previously at. So that's pretty handy for having these kind of trail effects. But that's basically it for distance. We'll be seeing it a little bit more later, but right now let's create a little explosion using what we've learned so far. So let me move this over here so we can see it a little bit more clearly. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is change the shape to a sphere. Now I'm going to be going over this a little bit more in the next video, but basically what it does is it changes how the particles are spawned and what their starting speed is going to look like, and basically that direction. So, then we're going to want to change the particle emission to time, which it's already at, and we're going to want it to have it spawn 0 particles per second and instead have a burst of about 30 particles right when it spawns. So, right now it looks kind of funny, so let's change a couple of these variables to make it look a little bit better. So let's change the lifetime to 1 to make the particles a little bit less on the screen, and then change the duration also to 1 so that we can see what's happening a lot more easily, so we can edit it a little bit more quickly. Let's change the size of the particles a little bit, and then also change the size of our sphere emitter to be a little bit smaller. We should also add a gravity effect to make it look a little bit more convincing. Could also probably make the size a little bit smaller and then increase the number of particles that we are spawning. So I guess we could change the color now, make it a little bit more orange so it looks more like a spark than a little white ball. Let's change it to a little bit more yellow. That looks about fine. And that's, well, basically it. So that's a very simple explosion effect that we'll be able to improve later using some of the tabs over here, like color over lifetime and size over lifetime, so we can make it look a little bit more convincing. But that's a basic explosion effect that you can use just using emission and shape. That's about it. Next week I'll be going a little bit more into detail over shape, and then yeah, thanks for watching. If you have any suggestions, leave them in the comments. If you want me to go over something specific or go over something in more detail, let me know, and I'll be happy to make a video on it later. All right, I'll see you.